Come in. We need to talk to you.
Yes.
About what?
Rio.
How about ratings?
What do you mean ratings?
Have you guys seen the show? Your ratings are down. Come on, you haven't even gotten them up from the first episode.
Oh, don't you talk about ratings. Rio is ruining our show.
Well, he apparently made it better with his little insert. The ratings went up.
Oh, no, she did not.
Well, like, if he takes over our show, it's going to ruin the ratings worse. We need our show back.
Why are you guys worrying about Rio when you won't even have a show?
If Rio ruins the show, we won't have a show to get ratings for.
Yeah.
We need to know where Rio is right now, Miss Producer.
You know the last people he had on his show? Shabinga and what's her name?
Flailer. Yes.
Well, they're supposed to be your guests.
What?
Not Rio's.
What is that? How did he get them?
Well, apparently he took them from you.
We need to find them. Yes, they would know. Get that. We need that info. Stat. Oh my goodness, how could he steal our guest?
I can't believe that. That's horrible.
Our first guest.
You have to promise me that the ratings will go up.
We'll work on it.
Ratings, people!
Welcome to Green Pepper Press. Today we're doing movie reviews for Harry Potter, Sands of Oblivion, and we're going to preview the new movie coming out this week, G.I. Joe. But where is Dr. Shigatsu?
I'm here.
What's up, Dr. Shigatsu?
I'm trying to find those people the producer told us about.
Any luck?
I couldn't find anything.
Well, we can continue looking afterwards. Alright, first thing we're going to do is review Harry Potter. Now, what did you think?
I thought Harry Potter was a good movie. I mean, for the people that read the book, it might not have been the same, but
Well, books and movies never compare. I have never heard once that someone likes the movie more than the book, but, you know,
sure.
It's almost impossible to copy a 300-page book into a movie. Was it that long?
No.
Oh, well, my bad. I did not read it like you did. You had more resources than I did. Well, I liked it more than the last one before it. It was a lot of magic, but they threw in a few different things. Seemed a lot of people were, how would they say, horny in this movie.
Portray it that way, yeah.
Yes, all the kids were, they're hitting on each other and, you know.
They were just snogging.
Yes, they were smogging each other all over the place, which we can translate it as kissing. Smogging is kissing. I was kind of confused when I heard that word. I was like, what's a smogging? But yes, that was going on. I don't know. What did anything you thought of it?
Just plenty of magic and excitement, and definitely a good cliffhanger too.
Yes. It kept very interesting. The only thing at the end is I wish Harry had more passion when he confronted the bad guy. We don't want to ruin too much, but you know, there was one part where Harry just kind of seemed to lack passion, or he should have been like grr, but he was like meh, 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 and then he fell down. But all right.
What do you rate the movie then?
I rate this movie 4 sticks.
Wands. Wave?
Wands. 4 wands out of 5. It was very good, but could have been a little better.
That's true.
No, you had a movie you wanted to present to us.
The second movie I have for everybody is called Sands of Oblivion.
Ooh, that sounds exciting.
It does, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Sands of Oblivion.
And the cover of the jacket cover is a big demon, and so it looks really exciting.
Can't go wrong with demons.
And basically it's about archaeologists, and they discover an old pyramid movie set. And, you know, they're shenanigans ensue. There's the curse of, like, the movie set and everything.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And, to be quite honest, the movie sucked.
Really? Why do you say? Was it the graphics that were the problems? I always have a hard time with graphics in
movies.
They
put computer graphics, really elaborate computer graphics, where
yes.
It wasn't necessary at all.
Really?
And you could tell when there was a little mini model, and it falls apart. And
oh, that's horrible.
It was a pretty disgusting movie to watch, actually.
Oh, that's too bad. That's too bad.
Mm-hmm. So, as far as ratings for Sands of Oblivion,
what would you give it?
It probably gets a -1 crappy model of 5.
Oh my goodness, 1 crappy model of 5. That is the lowest rating we have ever given anything on Green Pepper Press. Oh jeez,
it was that horrible.
How could a movie sink so low? Well, Sands of Oblivion, you heard it from Dr. Shigatsu. Now the next thing is we're going to do is preview what is that? You did that again?
Again?
No, 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 I thought we were going to say no, no!
I jacked Green Pepper Press again, and I'm the director of Tomato Ketchup Press, and I'm sick of being called Rio, so I named myself, Halloween. Ah, look how good magician I am. I changed this really fast. And now I'm gonna talk about Harry Potter. He's a really good magician, but not as good as I am. Watch. Well, I went to see Harry Potter, the Half-Blood Prince, and I really enjoyed it, because that's the one before the last one, and it was really good. While I was watching it, I was like, I wanted to be Harry Potter, just like this. I'm sure he can do like card trick like this. I'm sure he's good with wand, but never good with cards, in my opinion. Let's say, disappear. And let me do another one. Okay. Just goes to black. Just a little. Ball comes back. Let's see Harry Potter do that! Hope you enjoyed my Harry Potter review and my magic. Dr. Shigatsu and Jimbo Slice will never catch me. Catch up with you later.
Oh, how does Rio do that?
I don't know.
The producer told us she does not give him the keys. We really have to find out before he destroys this show. Oh, jeez. Well, let's get out of the show, and then we can go out to the contact information. Hopefully, we can find something with that contact information.
Yeah.
All right, so we're reviewing this week A Perfect Getaway. Mm-hmm. Now, do you know anything about this movie?
As far as I can tell, it seems like the movie is about a couple that gets married, and they go to an island for their honeymoon with a bunch of other people. And some of the people aren't exactly what they seem to be.
Oh yes, the whole go to a different island gimmick, and then there's not what it seems. Yes, mm-hmm. Starring Steve Zahn. Yes, he's a decent actor. Usually he's in comedy, so I like to see how he does in a serious movie. Mm-hmm. It kind of reminds me of The Ruins. You know, The Ruins. They went on this vacation, and then a vine pyramid ate them all. And so hopefully this movie will be good. I don't know. We like our horror movies, don't we?
I think it'll be good, though.
Oh, yes, it'll be excellent. So, go see The Ruins of Steve Zahn. It'll be very, very cool.
Go see
hopefully.
The Perfect Getaway.
I mean, yes. The Getaway. I'm sorry. It reminds me of The Ruins. Haha. Well, one more thing you have to do before we go is look at that. I have to look at that contact information. Let me take a look at your research here. I may actually know this place.
Really?
Yes, I think we can find these characters.
We're going to go see.
Let's go right now. We can find them. Mm-hmm. No, you're going this way. Okay, good.
I think this is the place.
This has to be the place. Let's go.